set, two encores. Maybe 12:15. Yeah, gotta go. Mr. Frank Sinatra, ladies and gentlemen.
Give me a cigarette, will you?
Yeah, yeah, you look.
Match me.
There you go. What? Hey, I'm sorry, Frank.
There you go, Mr. Sinatra.
Thanks, doll.
You know the basic difference between men and women? Women will ask for directions, and men won't. If you're with your man tonight, ladies, and you get lost on the way home, before he'll stop and ask for directions, you'll end up on Gilligan's Island. Remember that show Star Trek? All those guys in the spaceship? To go boldly where no man has ever gone. They were lost. Moses. One thing you need to know about men. Men are exactly like tile. If you lay them right the first time, you can walk all over them the rest of your life.
Hank, give me a splash of bourbon.
What the hell is it?
Give me a bourbon.
Here's some Mr. Jack from Mr. S. There you are, sir.
All right. Here, cancel that. I want some hot tea.
Yeah, you don't want tea. Hot tea. Yeah, get him some tea. Come on, hot tea, 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 tea.
No, cancel that. Cancel that. Give me the bourbon.
Give him the bourbon. Give me the bourbon. Yeah, forget the tea. Here's your bourbon, Frank. Come here, you little prick. Let me teach you something about show business. Truth be known, if a doctor ever told me I had
6 months to live, I'd want her to come back and be with me. Mr. Sinatra? The longest goddamn 6 months
I ever spent. I miss my guys. Thank you very much. You've been a wonderful audience. It's my job to come out here and warm you up for your grandmaster. I miss my guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, my good friend and the chairman of the board, Mr. Frank Sinatra!
I'm gonna live till I die. I'm gonna laugh, stutter, cry. I'm gonna take the town and turn it upside down. I'm gonna live, live, live until I die. They're gonna say, what a guy. I'm gonna play for the sky. Ain't gonna miss a thing. I'm gonna have my fling. I'm gonna live, live, live until I die. The blues I'll lay low, I'll make them stay low. They'll never trail over my head. I'll be a devil till I'm an angel. But until then, hallelujah, gonna dance, gonna fly. I'll take a chance riding high. Before my number's up, I'm gonna fill my cup. I'm gonna live, 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 live. I'll lay low, I'll make them stay low. They'll never trail over my head. I'm gonna be a devil till I'm an angel. But until then, hallelujah, gonna dance, gonna fly. I'll take a chance riding high. Before my number's up, I'm gonna fill my cup. I'm gonna live, live, live.
And all the ships at sea. Let's go to Britt. Newsflash. If you had any doubt that Dean Martin can make it without Jerry, cast that doubt aside. Besides Martin's hit songs and sold-out concert appearances, his performance in The Young Lions as the happy-go-lucky Dame Chaser should do for him what From Here to Eternity did for his pal, perennial bad boy Francis Albert. And with his top 10 hit, Memories Are Made of This, and number one smash, Volare, it's safe to say Dino's a talent here to stay.
Oh, Nelly, how'd y'all get in my room?
Hey, Dean, Miss Jerry?
That question's so old, it's biblical, pal.
Love you, too, you too.
Here comes Dino. Let him run to 20,000 and tell him to call home immediately.
Hey, Charlie, mind if I take a whack? Gather around, everybody. Ooh, well, what do you know? A drink for me? So, feeling lucky? You'll excuse me while we share a private moment here.
Hit me.
26. A winner. My table, new rules, doll.
Excuse me.
Sorry to disturb you, Mr. Martin, but Mr. Sinatra is on the phone.
Madon, il padrone himself. Well, you tell him I'm busy.
He says it's urgent.
Frank was born urgent, pal. Well, you'll all excuse me. Nature calls. Hey, Dago, is that you? What is it?
Dana, where have you been? We've been looking all over for you. Say hello to Momo and Hank.
Hey, what am I, invisible? Hey.
Is that other skinny Jew?
Where you been?
Joey. Fellas.
Good, how you doing, Dino?
How you doing, Joey? How was the play?
Hey, listen, Momo, I'm spreading some of your wealth around here tonight.
Hey, zip it, Cavone. What do you think, we're on a golf course?
Look, Dean, did you get that script that I sent you?
Oh, you mean Hamlet? You know I don't look good in tights, Frank.
No, you idiot. Some came running. Don't make me spend 3 months in Indiana by my lonesome, all right?
Listen, Dickie Bird, my character's a card shark with a taste for booze and broads. That might be too much of a stretch.
Hey, Frank, no part for a brilliant comic who never knows when to shut up?
Shut up.
All right.
Look, I'm not going to do this without you, and that's all there is to it. Now, listen to me. I sent the wings for you tonight. We're going to be catching Sammy's midnight show at Ciro's.
Well, you send it back, Dig. I'm busy. I got a nice little piece of Brijol right here. Besides, I've got my own show tomorrow night.
I can Sammy dance with one eye anyway. Doesn't that mess with your whatchamacallit?
It's your equilibrium. Give me a splash of bourbon.
Yeah, sure, Frank. Yeah, get the bourbon.
You know what? Cancel that.
Forget the bourbon.
Listen, Dean, I got it all planned out. You take the plane, we'll catch Sammy's show, we'll grab some ring-a-ding, we'll take the chopper to the Springs for a mid-morning clam bake, and I'll have you back at the Oasis by showtime. It'll be a gas.
Listen, Charlie, you are the Eisenhower of the night, but you're gonna have to storm the beaches without me this time. Now, you give my love to the merry Negro, Joey, Momo. I'll see you later, fellas.
Tata bon.
See you later, dear.
See you.
Could you believe him? He's the only guy in the world who could say no to me, and I gotta tell you, I still love him.
Hey. I can say no to you.
I know, but I don't love you when you do.
Yeah, but I still love you.
Come on, let's get out of here. Bishop.
After you, boss.
You got a watch?
Yeah, but I was on New York time.
Well.
Thank you. Wow. It is great to be back. It's great to be back. There was a time about 4 years ago after the accident that I thought I might never perform for you again. But the old man upstairs, I guess he wasn't through with me yet. And I... Thank you. And there are some people who I simply have to thank. People without whose support I would have just curled up and died, baby. There is Eddie Cantor, the man who gave me my Star of David. The only night I haven't worn it in 5 years was the night of the accident. Eddie Cantor. Eddie Cantor, ladies and gentlemen.
I love you, Sammy.
Thank you, Eddie. Thank you, man. From the bottom. I mean that, from the bottom. And last but never least, a man who gave my pop and my uncle and I our first break a dozen or so years ago. A man who got me gigs at clubs that wouldn't have me in the audience until he got me a table there too. A man who picked me up when I was so very, very down. My leader. More importantly, my friend. Mr. Frank Sinatra. I'm over here, Frank. Frank, I'm over here.
Sammy, let me ask you this. How's your bird?
It was my eye, Frank. It was my left eye.
Oh! You know, thank God for that, Sammy, because eyes, you know, we got two of.
Yeah.
But when your bird can't fly, you're earthbound, baby. Welcome back, Sammy Davis Jr., ladies and gentlemen.
Frank, come on, baby.
Mr. Davis. Mr. Davis? Sorry to disturb you, but Frank thought you might like a little breakfast.
Look, George, I don't want to be Charlie ungrateful here or anything, but how about just a piece of rye toast? Burn, you know?
All right.
George, stop calling me Mr. Davis, all right, baby?
All right, Mr. Baby.
Second day of 1960, Senator John Fitzgerald Kennedy has thrown his hat into the ring for the Democratic presidential nomination.
Mm-hmm. Is Mom up yet?
Not yet.
Conference being held in the Senate.
Oh, wait,
here,
George.
Washington.
Over here, Senator.
Betty.
Senator, do you think it's really possible for a Catholic Harvard man with a New England accent to win in the South?
No, but whomever he is, I wish the poor fellow luck. Apropos of that, I just received the following wire from my generous father. Bobby? It reads as follows. Dear Jack, don't buy a single vote more than is necessary. I'll be damned if I'm going to pay for a landslide.
You see? Now, that's a big leaguer, George. That's a big leaguer. He knows exactly what everyone's thinking, and what does he do? He walks right into the lion's mouth, and he pulls up a chair. That's guts, baby. That is guts.
Yeah, he's a playboy.
So what? So are you. What does that have to do with anything?
But I ain't running for president. Oh, Frank, Rocky Cooper called. The Crumb is definitely coming to her party on the 17th, so I told her you declined the invite as usual.
Does he bring his new bride?
Mrs. Patricia Kennedy Lawford. I do believe she mentioned that as the main reason she couldn't say no to the Crumb. Yes.
Call her back, George. Tell her I'm coming.
Whatever you say.
George, tell her I want to sit next to Mrs. Crumb.
That ought to be something to see.
Thank you all very much. We'll see you again.
Yep.
Hello, bad boys.
Rocky.
There she is. I thought you'd never.
How are you, doll? How are you? Brought my caddy. Thought we'd play a few holes in your backyard. Is that right?
What do you want to drink?
Bourbon and Coke.
Bourbon and water. I don't mix my drinks, political parties, or races. Right, Sammy?
Yes, Bull.
Oh, you are so rough and gruff. I love that about you.
You do, do you?
Uh-huh.
You're beautiful.
Dean coming.
Oh, you know, he said he wanted to stay home with the family, watch a Western. You know, Dean.
Well, nobody knows Dean, doll.
He's not a mouthful. Who is that?
Who?
That. The blonde with the eyes and the shape and the yum.
That's my Britt. She was the girl that was in the Young Lions with Dean.
Huh.
But I think she's quite fast enough for you, Sammy.
Well, I'll limp, sweetheart. Is she single?
Oh, she's single, but I warn you, she turns down everybody, including Dean.
Yes, well, watch my smoke, sweetheart. Excuse
All right,
me.
I'm watching.
Smokey!
Yeah.
Think taller.
Oh, good tip, babe. Nick. Baby.
Rocky, where's the crumb? I don't see the crumb.
Oh, his TV show is shooting late. Stop calling him the crumb. Peter's very charming, and he's a Democrat, too.
Is that Sister Kennedy?
Mrs. Peter Lawford.
How I've wanted to meet you, Frank.
It's a pleasure, sweetheart.
Oh, my God, he called me sweetheart. Wait till I tell Jack.
Shall we have a seat?
Thank you.
Rocky.
Excuse me, Miss Britt.
Tell me.
Tell you? Well, you're beautiful, I'll tell you that much. My name is Sammy.
Sammy Davis Jr. I know, I saw your Broadway show. Mr. Wonderful. It was the most amazing thing I ever see.
Oh.
Is that right? See?
No, actually, it's saw.
Ah, yes, I get my tensions confused.
Oh, that's all right. I get tense, too, from time to time, baby.
You call everybody baby.
Well, it's easier than remembering all these cuckoo names.
My name is Mai. It's spelled May, but it's pronounced Mai. Can you remember that?
Yes. Every time I see you, I'll think, my oh my.
Jack's your biggest fan, you know. He loves all those, what do you call it, those? Oh, your Franken-slang, that's it. What is that anyway, all those delicious words you use?
Just a way of saying what you want to say when you don't want the stiffs who run things to know what you're saying. Mm-hmm. That's all.
It's just a way of being naughty.
No wonder Jack said you're the one man in the world he'd like to trade places with.
Really? Huh. Well.
Nice to see you again.
Peter! Darling, you made it.
Darling, I'm so sorry. Mwah, so sorry I'm late. There's this rather bad actress at the studio. She keeps forgetting her lines. Hello, darling. And you know, so they keep on...
Oh, my God. Rocky, how could you do this? This is... That's Frank.
Now, Peter, just...
I think he's nervous.
Come on. Everybody knows about you, Frank and Ava. I mean, it's all news.
What do you mean everybody knows? There's nothing for anybody to know, which is why nobody knows anything. They know nothing. The studio set up a dinner, and a photo was taken, and that's it. That's it, Rocky.
Peter, just pull yourself together.
No, I can't do this. I can't do this. The last time I spoke with Frank, he threatened to have my legs broken. Hey, he's in with you, those you-know-who. It's a madman.
You know, that was years ago. Frank, I mean, he's matured. I mean, he was carrying Ava's baggage then. I mean, he was nearly suicidal.
Yeah, nearly.
Well, I mean, serious attempts.
Miss, shall I recount you the gory details?
Oh, no, please
because
don't.
Because they were gory.
Please don't.
Hello. Hi. Hey, Sammy. Hi.
Peter, how are you doing?
Good to see you, darling. Hello. Sweetheart.
It's who I've been talking to.
Yeah.
I don't speak to your old man, you know.
Oh, yes, I know. He's very scared of you. But that's changed since I've married him. I've transformed him.
Into what?
Into a Kennedy, of course.
I wouldn't leave this woman alone too often, Peter. She's got a way with words.
Yeah, she certainly does, Frank.
I think we should go have a talk.
Sure.
Excuse me, won't you, Pat?
Of course.
Rocky?
Of course.
Excuse us. After you, Frank. No, please, I insist.
Peter.
Sure.
What is it about that man?
Oh, you want to fuck him? You want to mother him? You don't want to piss him off. Oh, God, is it a combination?
You know, when I first met Joe Kennedy, he told me that I possessed the two qualities that he most despised in a man. I'm an actor, and, I'm English.
Well, you obviously charmed him, Cyril.
Oh, not really. you know? He hired a spy who told him that I had this certain penchant for ladies, young ladies who come for a, how should I put it,
A price?
Yeah, a very reasonable price, Frank.
I'm sure you always were a little tight, Cyril. So what happened?
Well, he was so overjoyed that I wasn't a poofter that he welcomed me wholeheartedly into the family. Which has its perks, of course, apart from their predisposition to die in tragic circumstances.
Sins of the father, no doubt. I want to help Jack get elected. Lest we wind up with another stuffed shirt. This country needs some shaking up. And I don't mean by Elvis.
Is that why you're talking to me?
Don't be so insecure, okay? I've always liked you. And you just crossed me.
Oh, well, that time with Ava, it wasn't a date, Frank. I swear to God, it was just...
No, don't bring God into it. He's disappointed in both of us. I'm an 18-carat manic depressive. You know that. I overreacted. A little. I do miss her, though. The insanity... All of it, believe it or not. Just can't seem to let go. Maybe because you can't let go of what you never really had, huh, Cyril?
Yeah.
So you want to have some fun?
Yeah.
Help me put your brother-in-law in the White House. I mean, what else is there for a skinny wop like me to accomplish in this world, huh?
I can't think of anything, Frank.
Everyone is voting for Jack, 'cause he's got what all the rest lack. Everyone wants to back Jack. Jack is on the right track,
'cause he's got high hopes. He's got high hopes. 1960's a year for his high hopes.
Come on and vote for Kennedy.
Vote for Kennedy,
and we'll come out on top.
Oops, there goes the opposition girl.
Oops, there goes the opposition girl.
Oops, there goes the opposition girl.
K-double-N-E-D-Y, Jack's the nation's favorite guy.
Everyone wants to back Jack. Jack is on the right track,
'cause he's got high hopes. He's got high hopes. 1960's the year for his high hopes.
Come on and vote for Kennedy.
Vote for Kennedy.
Keep America strong.
Kennedy. He just keeps rolling along.
Kennedy, he just keeps rolling up.
Kennedy, he just keeps rolling along.
Come on and vote for Kennedy.
Vote for Kennedy.
Keep America strong.
Kennedy, he just keeps rolling along.
Kennedy, he just keeps rolling up.
Kennedy, he just keeps rolling along.
Right, thank you, thank you, thank you. Shut up already, shut up. It's time to get serious for a moment.
Oh, that's my cue, not all.
Yeah, get back, get here, back here,
get right back,
back
here.
Back here. Look, there's a reason why we're all here tonight.
You threatened us. Did he threaten you too, Sammy?
I refuse to answer that on the grounds that it might incinerate me, baby.
Don't you mean incrimination?
Baby, once you've been incinerated, you don't care if you get incriminated.
Do you see why I want to get into politics? I can't have a serious conversation with these two bums. Seriously, folks. We're gathered here tonight to raise money for a man that I met briefly when I sang at the Democratic Convention in 1956. He gave a speech that night. And let me tell you something. When you hear Jack Kennedy speak, you don't forget it. So I don't have to say too much about why I think he should be the next president of the United States. He can take care of that just fine. Thank you very much. It's an honor for me to introduce to you the senator from the great state of Massachusetts, John Fitzgerald Kennedy. Jack, come on up here. Jack Kennedy, everybody.
Jack Kennedy. Thank you. And a special thanks to you, Frank, for arranging this. It's an honor to be on the same stage with you, with all of you. Good evening. My name is John Kennedy, Jackie Bouvier's husband. Unfortunately, she couldn't be here tonight, but I wanted to be sure that I get all your autographs so that I can prove that I was really here. Ladies and gentlemen, we live in extraordinary times, times of great promise and great peril. In Chinese, the word crisis is composed of two characters. One represents danger, the other opportunity.
Look at him.
Perhaps.
He's got them in the palm of his hands. I love this guy. More self-evident
than here in Hollywood. Take a peek at Marilyn, Pally. If she gets any more humid, we're all gonna need umbrellas.
No, look at DiMaggio. Lifetime 325 center fielder for the Yankees, and now he's Charlie Ballboy.
Different league, Buster.
No problem in a world
league.
Full of problems calls for greater leadership or vision than the control of nuclear weapons. The utter destruction which would result from their use in war are the real issues that face us today.
I'm the one trying to stay on the up and up here.
What about when you get hit with the pie? The fellow says, what's the point of power if you don't abuse people?
I remember that.
He gets it right in the eye, and he can't see it. He can't see that.
So, do you serve Southern Italian food at your place, Joe?
Sure.
What does he serve? I tell you, when they would say four balls, Joe would think they were talking about meatballs, usually. But if it's Northern Italian food that you're interested in, Jack, you have to go north. San Francisco, one of the little ironies of living in L.A.
I feel a punchline coming. Why is that, Dean?
Because Frank has outlawed it.
That's not true. I'm not sure that's a proper use of your power, Frank. I think we'll have to get my brother here to launch an investigation.
Uh-oh.
What do you say, Bobby?
Well, seeing as how I share Frank's passion for Southern Italian food, I see no need to authorize an investigation at this time.
Dodged a bullet. Cheers.
All right, Brother Bobby. Not cheers for Brother Bobby.
You checked anything.
Now, if Momo would show up, we'd have a full house, eh, buddy boy? Politicians, movie stars, mobsters.
Untouchables.
And all the bacteria you need for life itself.
Well, look what we have here. Hey, Mickey. I see you clean Bugsy's blood off your shirt. Is that a Cuban cigar in your hand by any chance?
Mickey going.
And Johnny Roselli.
Roselli?
Well, well, where Johnny is, can Momo be far behind?
Don't write the party. Don't turn around and look at the man.
No,
turn
please.
Around, look at the man.
Is a moulinant
right this way.
The bubbles.
Well, thank you, everyone. But I'm afraid we're expected somewhere else.
We are?
Yeah. We have that thing, remember?
Well, I'm not leaving. I'm having fun.
Marilyn. Don't contradict me in front of everyone. Let's just go.
Are you still my husband? I thought I had a new one. What's his name? You know, the one who wrote Death of a Mailman.
You know, I think it's about time I roll down out of here myself.
married life. You know what I'm talking about, fellas.
You know, it's very late in the game for me, too.
By the way, Joe, listen, why don't you explain to me about that infield fly rule? I never could quite understand that. Listen, don't embarrass yourself, Joe. Let Frank handle it, okay?
I'll get the car.
Norma, sweetheart, you should leave with Joe. All right, you're gonna regret it tomorrow if you don't.
He isn't my husband anymore. He's just a fuddy-duddy.
I know, but he's an Italian fuddy-duddy, and you're making him lose face, sweetheart. Come on. Okay?
You're right, Frankie. Thanks.
Okay.
Jack, I'm sorry for the embarrassment.
Marilyn, please, don't even think about it. It was a pleasure.
You too, Bobby. My, Sammy.
All right, Marilyn.
Here you
go, sweetheart. Good night. Jack, see you. Good night. Cool.
Bye.
I don't want to be Charlie Trembles here, but why don't you go on out ahead of me? There may be some photographers out there.
I don't care.
Shh. Look, your studio does, Mile, right? Dean will take you home, and then I'll swing by your place a little later, all right?
My God, would you look at that? These guys can screw anybody, anybody they want.
Make sure you give him my number, will you, Peter?
Of course I will.
Thank you. You promise?
Greatest ass in the history of the world. And it's laid out for him on a plate. Like a deli spread.
Hi, Joe. Take care.
Hi, Judy Campbell. I'm here to see Frank.
How about, would you like a cigar? That's a Monte Cristo number one. Yeah, with Jason all things.
Little chicky baby, it's just you, me, and the Girl Scouts.
Your place or mine?
We'll go to my place. You could have the presidential suite. How's that?
They're not just going to hand me the keys to the White House, Frank. If I want to get to Nixon, I have to step over Humphrey first.
Jack, let me tell you something. No one named Hubert will ever be president. It's just like in the movies, except you're going up for the part of president. Now, having done a couple movies myself, I can tell you, Edward G. Robinson doesn't play Gary Cooper parts. He plays Edward G. Robinson parts. He plays the bad guys, the shady guys. He doesn't play the hero. You're gonna be going toe-to-toe with Richard Nixon for the romantic lead in a movie called Presidential Politics. Who do you think's gonna get the girl? Huh? Right here.
Speaking of which,
they're interested.
Which one you want? Or do you want both of them?
Oh, I know him well. Really well.
Who's the one who looks like Elizabeth Taylor?
I had a feeling. That's Judy Campbell. She looks like Elizabeth Taylor, only better. You don't have to marry her to sleep with her. Life is good.
Hello? Bobby?
What's wrong?
It's 5 a.m. I'm just, I'm getting up. Wait a minute.
Bobby? Can I call you back, Bobby? Well, it's Marilyn. She came over at about 3 o'clock this morning in a state that, hang on, can only be described as shaky. And, I've been up all night, you see.
Yeah, she's quite a handful.
Mm-hmm. No, I haven't slept with her. But I do hear that she's overrated. What?
Hoodlums? Mickey Cohn.
The Puccinis. Uh-huh. So what?
It's a restaurant, Bobby. Frank doesn't control whoever goes to...
I'll do anything for the family, Bobby. You know that. But I can't just go... All right. I'll see what I can do then, Bobby. Fucking Kennedys!
Right, exactly. Exactly. No. I got you down for $10,000. Gene, what do you mean five? You said $10,000, Gene.
Don't give me that Catholic crap, right? Any other candidate, yes, I would agree. But Kennedy is rewriting the rule books, Gene, I'm telling you.
Good morning, George.
Morning, Miss Campbell.
Wait, hold on. Morning, Judy.
Morning.
Is he up yet?
Oh, he's up all right.
Gene, all right, look, I'm putting you down for $10,000. I want you to make the check out to the Kennedy campaign.
Yeah,
I promise you. Front row seat at the inauguration, how's that? Okay, thanks.
Good morning,
Cyril. How's your bird?
Gentlemen, the bird has flown.
We should go up to Sun Valley, Frank, go skiing.
Sure, Jack, I'd love to. Just had a little chat with you-know-who this morning, and Pat's out of town next month. Thought we might have a little clam bake at the beach. Can you make a campaign stop?
Well, what about the center fielder?
Ah.
Is he coming out of retirement? It looked like he was.
He dropped the ball.
Well, then let's circle the bases.
There you go, Frank.
Good idea.
Hey, wait, George. Are you hungry, Jack? You know, get Jack the house special. Oh, George.
And tell him how you feel about civil rights. He's going to be president. He should know.
Doesn't matter what I think.
Why is that, George?
Because it doesn't matter what the Negro thinks in this country. I mean, the few who do vote are all tied up with those Democratic machines in the North. I mean, hell, they'd vote for Adolf Hitler in Chicago if Mayor Daley told him to. And, Senator, no politician can win in the South if he offends old Jim Crow. And even if he did, a Negro still can't vote down there anyway, can he?
You may be right, George. I'll be sure to share your feelings with Martin Luther King next time I see him.
Well, if you get an office, Senator, you won't have to ask him. He'll tell you.
Thanks, George.
Yeah. Woo-hoo! Good business. I mean, not that I want to impose on our relationship in any way, but is it any good?
What's that?
It's your script, sir. Oh, your script. Wonderful. Is it any good? The script's wonderful, Frank. I bought the rights from a friend of mine, and I thought...
Just happens to be a part for you.
You know, I can't get arrested in features these days, Frank, but there's a devilishly good part for you in it. And for Dean, too, and Sammy, even, if the studio doesn't mind
taking a little... I am the studio, Cyril.
Oh, you certainly are the studio.
What's
Frank?
It called?
It's called Ocean's 11. It's
a lousy title, believe it. I'll read it.
Yeah, it's a lousy title. But you'll read it?
Yeah.
Thanks. I really appreciate this.
And, you know, I think it's wonderful that...
Knock it off.
Right.
I owe you, Peter.
You're doing me a favor, and I appreciate it.
You give me a chance to change my image. And wait till the goddamn press sees me in the White House with the president. That'll shut those sons of bitches up.
Right. Yeah. Speaking of your image, Frank, just that Bobby mentioned that he saw Mickey Cohen eating at Puccini's. So?
So? Is there any law against having a plate of spaghetti?
Exactly what I said.
He mentioned it. Don't squirm, Peter. I hate it when you squirm.
Thank you, George. Yeah, right. Jack, it's just Jack is so vulnerable to Hoover, who hates the Kennedys with a passion bordering on pathology.
I never apologize for my friends.
Right.
Not even you.
Thank you.
When I was flat on my ass a few years ago, guys like Johnny and Momo were the only ones who would give me a job. And believe me, I wasn't packing them in back then.
Absolutely.
Open your eyes, Peter. Jack's a bootlegger's son who likes to fuck them two at a time. If that fruitcake in the FBI wanted to do something, he would have done it by now, don't you think?
Right.
Well.
Yes. And before I forget, Bobby also mentioned... He mentioned that you were going to hire a writer called Albert Maltz to write a script for you.
Jesus.
Yes, I'm hiring Albert Maltz. So what? He's a great screenwriter. But he's a communist, isn't he? He's blacklisted.
Albert Maltz is just a screenwriter. That's it. He thought the country was giving the working man a raw deal 30 years ago, and who didn't? So did Ronald Reagan. Kirk Douglas is using Trumbull for Spartacus. If he could do it, you don't think I can, Peter?
Yeah. Kirk Douglas isn't a presidential candidate's friend. He's not Jack Kennedy's friend, if you see, if you get my drift.
Stand up, Peter.
Why?
I said stand up.
Right.
How tall are you?
6'2".
Don't cut yourself off at the knees.
The brouhaha of a Sinatra's hiring a blacklisted screenwriter, Albert Maltz, to write the film vehicle of the execution of Private Slovak escalated today as actor John Wayne spoke out against Sinatra. Wayne said, I quote, I wonder how Sinatra's crony, Senator John Kennedy, feels about him hiring such a man. I'd like to know his attitude because he's the one who was making plans to run the government of our great country.
I got some things in the trunk.
Brian, if you would, please. Okay. Ambassador Kennedy's in the study.
Great.
Sinatra bought full-page ads in the trades, which state, quote, I do not ask the Senator for advice on whom I should hire, and he doesn't ask me how he should vote in the Senate. I hire the best man for the job, and I am prepared to await the verdict of the American people when they see the picture.
Well, there he is. Had a nice ride?
It was perfect, Ambassador, thank you. I brought you some fresh baked Italian bread and some other delectables.
Marvelous. Jack Daniels, still your drink?
You've done your homework, yes, sir.
Jack Daniels for Mr. Sinatra. I understand you and Jack have been having a nice time together.
Oh, we've had a few laughs. How much have you heard?
Enough. Frank.
Yes, sir.
About this Maltz fellow. I'm too old to beat around the bush, so I'll come right out with it. I admire your courage, but if you don't fire him, I'm afraid you can't continue to associate yourself with the campaign. It's bad enough Jack gets banged around for being a Catholic. He can't be pro-communist, too.
Ambassador, Albert Maltz is not a communist. He's a screenwriter. He's a Jew who sits in front of a typewriter all day and doesn't get enough sun. That's it.
He's history.
I already made a commitment to him.
You made a mistake. The bigger the man, the bigger the mistake. That's all. Just pay him off and do what you have to do to save face. But do it. Marilyn Monroe could have sex with every opinion maker in the country, and it wouldn't make a difference if they think Jack is soft on the commies.
I understand.
Now, there's another matter. I need a favor.
I thought you just asked for one.
Well, that was a favor to you. This one's for me. We need Humphrey out of the race, and the only way to do that is to smash him in West Virginia. Jack won Wisconsin, but he was waxed in all four Protestant districts.
Know much about West Virginia, Frank?
Coal miners and canaries, that's all I know.
And Protestants, Frank, millions of them, 95%. We lose there. And our opponents in both parties will say a Catholic can't win the South, and Jack won't get the nomination. But it's critically important for Jack to get the support of the state's political machine.
The Teamsters will never endorse Jack. Not after Bobby's witch hunts, they won't.
Perhaps not publicly, no.
Are we on the same wavelength?
I'm a saloon singer, but I'm not stupid. Let me get this straight. What you're saying is you know Jack can't win in West Virginia. And you want me to go to my friends and make sure he does. Right?
They must realize there's no direct quid pro quo. Jack can't be beholden to these people. It'll have to be a favor they do for you. And to an extent for me.
I got it. Just get the car and drive.
Newsflash. Finally bowing to pressure from within and without Hollywood, Frank Sinatra instructed his attorneys to pay writer Albert Maltz in full and inform him that he will not write the screenplay for the execution of Private Slovak after all. When asked, Sinatra said, quote,
I have defended my hiring of Mr. Maltz, but the American public has indicated otherwise, and I will accept this majority opinion. Sinatra issued no other public statement.
Have you talked with him?
Listen, honey, the reason Frankie and I get along so well is we try to keep it light. We talk about music, golf, movies. Nice and simple.
Well, if you don't talk to Frank, then who do you share your intimate feelings with, Dean? Mind me asking?
Jeannie, in order to share intimate feelings, you have to have intimate feelings.
Dinner's almost ready.
Save me a seat.
Do you ever sleep?
No.
So? Have you thought about what we talked about on the golf course?
I thought about it. Tell me. Who's the doll that looks like Elizabeth Taylor?
It's Judy Campbell. Judy, this is Sam Flood. It's Judy Campbell.
Hi, Sam.
She looks like Liz Taylor, but you don't have to marry her to fuck her. You want a drink?
Certainly. No ice.
All right. So you're wearing the ring.
I always wear the ring.
That's not what I heard. I heard you weren't wearing it. You know, I gave you the ring as a symbol of lifelong friendship, and I heard you weren't wearing it, Momo.
Hey, I said I was wearing the ring. What are you, turning homo all of a sudden? Let me have a drink, for Christ's sake. Frankie, let's get on to it. Tell me, why should I do that Ivy League playboy and his Irish fuck father a favor?
Look at it this way, Momo, okay? You're gonna be doing me a favor.
You a favor?
Yeah.
Consider it done.
I won't forget it.
Oh, neither will I.
Everyone is voting for Jack. Cause he's got what all the rest lack. Everyone wants to back Jack. Jack is on the right track.
Cause he's got high hopes. He's got high hopes. 1960's a year for his high hopes.
This date will go down in the history books of the Democratic Party. July 13, 1960, Senator John Kennedy has received the party's presidential nomination on the first ballot. This makes Kennedy only the second Catholic candidate in the history of the nation. Party solidarity is high, with the exception of the Mississippi delegation, which booed Negro entertainer Sammy Davis Jr. as he led the convention in singing the national anthem. Although other voices drowned out the protest, Davis was noticeably shaken.
First collaboration, boys. Courtesy of brother in Lawford.
Ah, congratulations. Finally contributes something.
Well, you owe Crumpity to you.
Listen, we're going to shoot the picture in Vegas by day. Right, we're going to play the sands at night. We're going to tear up the town. And in our spare time, we're going to do our part for Jack.
Spare time? What spare time? I don't sleep good standing up, Frank.
Hey, Frank, is there, you know, something in this for me?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you're going to play a singing garbage man, Sam.
Now you're spoiling them.
No, but seriously, Frank, I mean, is, you know, is their part for me?
Sam, it's a great part. Don't worry about it. Just look at you worrying. You're getting wrinkles. There's a great part, okay?
All right.
Don't relax.
All right, whatever you say, journalist.
Sammy, you have got to play this part. There is singing, dancing, wonderful title song. It's yours, baby. It's yours.
Okay.
I'm confused here, Frank. You got a story here set in Vegas about Ocean starring a Schlemiel who sings about garbage.
I'm Ocean, Schmendrick. I'm Danny Ocean.
Schmendrick.
You bums are part of my old commando unit. We're ex-GIs who reunite to knock over some casinos. The plot's a gas or it's foolproof.
I say screw the movie. Let's just pull the job.
Yeah, I figure if power doesn't mean that you have the opportunity to work with the people that you love, then you haven't really got any.
Beautiful.
Beautiful, Captain.
Yeah.
Okay, Dick.
I'll do that.
All right. If I, Khrushchev, and De Gaulle, they could have their summit, then why can't we?
Oh, yeah, that's a good comparison. I'll be Khrushchev.
Somebody give me a ginger ale or something. What am I, chopped liver?
Hey, Frank.
Happy rewards to everybody. We all deserve it.
Yeah, very good.
L'chaim, Sam.
I'm for less thinking and more drinking. Yes, aye. Well, maybe I should just say aye.
Aye, aye.
And two for the Jews.
Who the fuck is that? Is that who I think it is? The reporter.
Yeah, that's the busboy.
Frank Sinatra, wannabe gangster. That's the guy who wrote it. Call me Ava's Gardner.
No, that guy's a liar.
Sammy, that's him. I'm telling you, that's him.
That's not him.
Call me a fucking sniveling mama's boy. That little fucking cock.
Easy, Frank.
Sucker.
Wait a minute. Hold it, Frank.
3 minutes in the nicest way, Frank.
Hey, bub. What the fuck are you doing in my restaurant?
It's still a free country, isn't it, Frank?
No, it's not. It's a very expensive country, and you're gonna pay a very serious price if you don't scram right now.
I paid for my drink.
Have them hold the appetizers.
Here. Get the hell away from me! Son of a bitch! Hold it, Frank! Come on, Frank! Get out of here! Come on!
You write that shit about me
come
again!
Come on, Frank! I'll fucking kill you!
Get out!
I'm gonna fucking sue you!
Get out!
Son of a bitch!
You want to take a crack at me, pal?
Shut up, Jimmy!
Come on, let's go. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay.
I'm sorry, everybody. Tony, everybody eats and drinks on the house, all right?
Ladies and gentlemen, direct from the bar at the Sands Hotel, Mr. Dean Martin.
How all these people get in my room? Maestro, how long have I been on? Hey there, you with the stars in your eyes. Love never made a fool of you. You look. There they are, folks. Tarzan, Jane, and the African Queen. Ooh. Well, I think I'm gonna make myself a little salad.
Let me help you out here a little. How about some lunch?
Frank, do you know how to make a fruit cordial?
No, Dean, how do you make a fruit cordial?
You'd be nice to him.
Do you believe in fairy godmothers?
No, but I have an uncle that I'm keeping an eye on.
Look at these two, ladies and gentlemen, the Italian bookends. Pretty soon they'll be telling you what wonderful work the mafia's been doing.
Hey.
Have you ever seen a jiu-jitsu?
Hey. Now, be fair. That's all I ask. How'd you like it if I said, have you ever seen a wop-sickle?
Hey.
Oh, jeez. Sorry, Frank is the boss.
I'm not really part of the show, folks. I just couldn't get a reservation. Two Italians against one Jew, Sammy. Come over here. I need your help. Get another Jew up here.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sammy Davis Jr.
And just hurry up here, Sam. Your watermelon's getting warm.
It's better than eating pizza every night.
Yeah, well, at least we don't have to spit out the crust.
Like it.
That's all, folks.
Porky Sinatra. No, but seriously, we'd like to start this entertainment off right, and I would like to begin by doing a few impressions. And the first one is of the kingfish.
I was down at the Mystic Night at the Sea Lodge with lightning, and we were talking to the girls down there. Hey!
If all the women in Texas were as ugly as your mama, the Lone Ranger gonna be alone for a long time, yes.
All right, you dirty rats, who's been playing bocce with my sister? Someone's gotta entertain, Sam.
Here we go.
Hey there.
Yes? Hey, you wanna lay off and go sit on the audience? Got a show to do here.
You used to be too wise. Hey there.
What the hell is it, Sam?
Sing us another tune, Sam.
You think someday she'll run to you.
Better forget her.
She'll have you dancing on a string. Break it, and she won't care. Won't you take this advice? I hand you like a brother.
Your mother, you mother.
Well, geez, ladies and gentlemen, he said half a word.
After the show, you're gonna hear the other half.
Bubby, please.
Whoa, whoa, Zelda, Zelda, Zelda. Whoa, 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 whoa. I'll sing with you. I'll dance with you. I'll pick cotton with you. I'll even go to a bar mitzvah with you, but don't touch me.
What do you think, Jack? You think we should grow up? Ladies and gentlemen, next president of the United States, Senator John F. Kennedy. Jack, take a bow. Jack Kennedy.
What was his name again? Senator, we'd like you to accept this award on behalf of the NAACP.
Put me down, you nitwit.
Casino giving out your autographs.
Good night, Frank.
Hey, do we kill tonight or what? We kill tonight. I wouldn't laugh like that since
I played a little club in Poughkeepsie in 1944.
What do you say? We were funny tonight.
What I'm saying is, watch this. Excuse me, ladies. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, so?
The whole world is drunk and we're just a cocktail at the moment, Pally. One of these days, everybody's gonna wake up with a heck of a hangover, down two aspirin with a glass of tomato juice, and wonder what the hell all the fuss was about. See you later, Joey.
Okay. Time to try out some new jokes.
Hey, look at that.
Good idea.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Okay.
Get out of here. It's getting late.
You just put your drinks over there.
Yeah. After you, Judy.
Yep.
Are you leaving, babe?
Dreamland calls, Pally.
Thanks
good
night, Senator.
Great evening, Sammy.
Hi, Frank.
Easy, Smokey.
You seen Mai?
Yeah, she's up there.
Hey, sweetie. Frank and Dean and everybody took off, so why don't we just go ahead and...
Why do let them make fun of you?
What? Who?
They all make fun of you on stage.
Oh, come on, baby. That's just a gas. You know, we rib each other. You know that.
No. There is of and there is with. Night after night, I study the difference. They make fun of you, not with you.
My, you're acting like Charlie Party Pooper here, okay?
I'm acting like I love you. I don't know why sometimes. All your gold and your flash and your babies all the time. I hate it. You're short. You're not good looking.
Oh. Gee, thanks. But I think you left something out, right, babe? Like skin color? Mine.
I never even saw your skin color, you idiot. I'm not your friend.
Listen. Sometimes Frank and the guys, they cross the line. Okay, and yes, sometimes it hurts. So I get a little dirt on my uniform. So what? The point is, I'm circling the bases. And the fellas that come up behind me, they're gonna have it easier. Can't you see that?
All I see is your heart. And your talent. And your courage. I don't care what our children look like, brown, white, polka dot. I just want them to have your courage.
Will you?
Yes.
People.
I don't care a damn. I never have.
You don't give a damn.
No, I don't. I guess good days.
And one guy being, I kissed her and she kissed me. Like the fella once said, ain't that a kick in the head? Her room was completely black. Well, I hugged her and she hugged back. Like the sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in the wall? My head keeps spinning. Go safe and keep grinning. If this is just the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. I've sunshine enough to spread. It's just like the fella said. Tell me quick, ain't love a kick in the head? My head keeps spinning. I go safe and keep grinning. If this is just the beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. I've sunshine enough to spread. It's just like the fella said. Tell me quick, ain't love a kick in the head? The fella once said, ain't that a kick in her hand? Like the sailor said, quote, ain't that a hole in a bone? My head keeps spinning. I go to sleep and keep grinning. If this is just a beginning, my life is gonna be beautiful. She's telling me we'll be wet. Oh, she's picked out a king-size bed. Oh, I couldn't feel any better. Oh, I'd be dead. Tell me quick. Oh, ain't love a kick. Tell me quick. Ain't love a kick. In love,
okay, let me have it. When do we blow this mausoleum?
Day after tomorrow, gentlemen. We'll be in Las Vegas. Happy New Year.
Mark it.
Tail slate 42, take one.
And cut. One more right away.
Why? What was wrong with that?
Nothing, Frank. I just want another for safety.
Safety? What, are we jumping out of an airplane? You said action. We did the scene. You said cut. That's it. It's over. Finita. Come on, boys. Let's take a steam.
Oh, we're schmitzing.
Take us down, Brady.
Coming down.
EO 11. Thanks,
Luke. Relax, Miley. It's only a movie.
Well, I guess that was a print.
Tell me quick. Oh, I love a kiss. Tell me quick. Kick in the head.
That's it. Yeah. That's the ticket. Those last four bars, that's how I want it. Yeah. Yeah. Right. All right, I'll talk to you in a week.
How you doing, Sam?
Pretty good, Skipper.
What's Mai? She sticking around?
Like glue, Daddy.
Attaboy.
We're getting married, Frank.
Sam, they're gonna crucify you.
Yeah, I know.
Is she up for it?
Well, she says she is. She just wanted to know why I haven't asked her to convert, you know, to become a Jewish. Told her we'd see about that when she learns how to say the J sound, babe.
She's a somebody, Sammy.
Yes.
You get married. You're a lucky man. All right.
Frank, I don't want to put you on the spot or anything, but I was hoping you'd stand up with me.
I'd be honored to stand up with you. It'd be an honor.
Quite sexy, actually. And she asked me, it was un rat.
What'd you say?
It was un pussy. Hey, listen to this. We're getting more press than Elvis these days.
And a good thing, too. Because that Elvis fella set such a bad example for the nation's youth.
People in Hollywood refer to Sinatra's gang as the Rat Pack, an offspring of the late Humphrey Bogart's Holmby Hills Rat Pack, whose exclusive ranks, including Mr. Sinatra, of course, were dedicated to drinking, carousing, and generally thumbing their noses at conventional morality.
Oh, right. Well,
thumb. You know, some people also refer to Sinatra's pack as the Klan.
With Sammy as a member?
If you're one of the Klan, you have to be cuckoo.
That leaves me out.
You have to be hip in their way of hip.
Oh, that leaves you out.
That definitely leaves you out, Cyril.
Yeah, well, you also have to have talent.
Ah, and that leaves us all out.
And nonconformity is now the key to social importance in Hollywood, and then, just sort of goes on.
Yeah.
What? Well, nothing. It's just crap, is it, Frank?
Just read it.
I'm not reading. And that angry middle-aged man, Frank Sinatra, is its prophet and reigning monarch. That Senator John Kennedy has associated himself with such childishness perhaps explains why he trails the less hip Richard Nixon in the polls. Crap!
Goddamn, give me this thing.
Bollocks. What the fuck do I have to accomplish for these people to give me some respect? Huh?
Greetings, fellow Klansmen. You know, looking at you guys naked, I see why God created clothing. Huh, what'd I say?
Nothing. Sammy?
Everybody, Sammy's got an announcement to make.
Actually,
Mai and I have decided to get married.
God damn it! A month of this horrendous publicity, and he still doesn't get it.
Dad, you have a stroke. Calm down.
Bad enough we had that Albert Maltz fiasco. Bad enough we have to drag the Pope and all his baggage down to Dixie with us. Now we've got the most prominent, visible members of this campaign as groom and best man at an interracial marriage.
It's not all bad, you know. I mean, the New York Times... The New York Times just this morning was saying some very nice things about Jack not backing away from Frank and...
People in Alabama don't read the New York Times, Peter. You just grab the first flight to the Springs, and you tell Frank he goes to that wedding, he'd feel like he's standing on the North Pole in his bare feet, so far as this family is concerned.
Believe me, Dad, I've tried.
Ah, Sinatra scares the piss out of you! You know what? Bobby, you call him. My son-in-law is too weak-kneed to stand up to big, bad Frank.
Save the white race! 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 Save the white race!
Dear nigger bastard. I see Sinatra is going to be best man at your abortion. It's good to know the kind of people supporting Kennedy before it's too late. And the idiot misspelled two twice. Nazis and death threats right here in Washington, D.C. It's cuckoo, huh, Big John?
Wait a minute, what are you doing, boss?
Look, I don't want to act like Charlie John Wayne, but I'm not going to let some crazed idiot jump on that stage without defending myself.
You can't go out there.
Can't go on with these first. But you have them ready, Big John. Because I'm going to move the gun tricks up early in the act, and then I just won't bother to take them off.
Hello? Yeah? All right, hold on.
It's Mr. Sinatra for you, boss.
Hey, Frank.
Hey, hold it up, Smokey.
Oh, I'm fine, Dad. How are you?
How about Mai? I hope she's wrapping her fish in those headlines.
Frank, she told me that you called, and you're wonderful. You know that?
I mean that. You're very, very special, Frank.
It's okay. It's okay. You just hang in there, Buster. I'll see you at the wedding.
Yeah, about that.
Smokey, can it. I'll see you soon.
Peter's here, Frank.
Hey, Cyril.
You will end up in the middle of the North Pole without shoes on your feet. Because of what? Interracial marriage. None of it whatsoever. He doesn't want anything.
Peter, just save it. All right, save it. It's 1960, for Christ's sake. Jack has the guts to face the music. I mean, God damn it. America's got to grow up. This is ridiculous.
Jack can't face the music from Palm Springs. He can't, you know?
George!
It's the power of the White House.
George, where are my cigarettes?
Yeah.
George! What?
Frank, it's Sammy. Yeah, well, wouldn't you know, my rabbi just called, and he's got a bar mitzvah booked that day. And,
there seems to be a slight hitch in getting the Escoffier room for the reception.
So, Mai and I have decided that, you know, we're going to go ahead and postpone the wedding for a few weeks.
We don't know
exactly when it'll be, but, you know, we'll be sure to give you plenty of notice.
You're lying, Charlie.
I'm just telling a different kind of truth, that's all.
Sam. You don't have to do this. You hear me?
You don't have to do this, Sam.
And not your wedding. I'd never ask that. I'd never ask this, Sammy.
I know.
happy?
Crackers couldn't afford a ticket. Thought I'd bring the show to you.
Showtime, Mr. Davis.
Now, for the first time, have
Do you know who this is? This is Frank Sinatra, and I want you to put me through to Nixon now. Listen, I know he's staying at the Ambassador, and I want the crumb to concede, so put him through now.
That we have between these
We did it, Dino. We did it. We're going to the White House. We're going to the White House.
Hey, Frankie.
Jack? Ava? How are you?
Well, I'm so proud of you. There's too much static, can you hear me?
It's the most beautiful static I ever heard.
Frank, you're breaking up, but I'm coming to L.A. soon and I'll call you.
Oh, yeah, I hear you. Call me. But...
Oh, what do you know?
What a night, Dino. What a night, Dean. Here we go. Here we go. One.
Frank!
Jack?
Hey, Canary.
Hey, Charlie Tommy Gun!
It's a moment.
Congratulations.
Just tell your pal we turned out the living and raised the dead in Chicago like it was a Catholic resurrection.
Great job! Thank you!
Go, Frank.
I love that guy. What a character.
Yeah, he's a real teddy bear.
So long, Nixon.
Frank Sinatra flew into Washington from his brand-new Cal Neva Casino on the shores of Lake Tahoe to stage the most star-studded inaugural gala in the history of the Republic, with the conspicuous absence of fellow rats Dean Martin and Sammy Davis. Martin claimed to have a movie commitment, even though Laurence Olivier shut down his Broadway show to attend. Davis, who postponed his marriage to My Britt until after the inaugural, also claimed to have other commitments.
10 days at the Fountain Blue, Dino. That's it.
Johnny, I wish that I could help you, but I'm booked solid for more than a year in advance now.
Between the movies and Vegas?
Shit, my youngest don't even know what I look like no more.
You realize that this request comes from Momo himself?
What, I got stupid all of a sudden? Besides, I'm booked into Cal Neva in October. Ain't that enough?
Cal Neva's got nothing to do with Sam.
Oh, yeah. And Jerry and I are still in act.
Frank's always available with Sam.
Well, you see, now Frank keeps a looser schedule than me because I got to work more since I got the 7 kids.
You got big balls, Paisan. That's what you got.
I'm just a hard-working guy, John.
So, what are you two a-holes up to?
He's a real manjafreguista, this one.
Yeah, that's why we love him. Those shrimp, they look good.
Hey! Uh-oh. Those are spoken for.
Salute.
Salute.
The happy relationship between the arts and politics, which has characterized our long history, I think reached culmination tonight.
Here it comes.
I know we're all indebted to a great friend, Frank.
Frank Sinatra!
Yeah,
that's
Frank. Come on, home. You're not playing this again,
are you? Hey,
Dino! People say bad things about me now? They're gonna be calling the President of the United States a liar.
Did you read the script, Sergeant's Three?
Oh, yeah. Gunga Din all over again, Pally.
Where do you get that?
Mm-hmm.
Gunga Din.
Oh, by the way, have you heard the news, boys?
What's that?
Brother Bobby made Attorney General.
Hey!
Ooh,
that's
good. Hey.
Wish I was a Kennedy.
Good.
Okay.
Yeah, sure.
When
did you hear that?
Oh, my dial is tuned, Frank. Nice to hear that a choir boy with a passion for sin will be watching out for us, huh? Fellas, excuse us for a minute, will you, please?
Yeah, sure. No problem. You
okay, Frank?
Yeah.
This goes better, right? Yeah.
All right. So Bobby made top cop. It's a surprise, I guess.
Hey, we're singers, not soothsayers, huh? Listen, I want to sell you my interest in the Cal Neva, Frank.
What? What are you talking about?
Hidden ownership, Charlie. Plucked a grape from the vine, got a sour taste from a bad seed named Momo. Want to spit it out?
Dean, come on.
I love you, Dago. You pay me to play there anytime. But Bobby's gonna have Momo's guinea ass in a frying pan, and I don't want him to use me for the seasoning.
That's never gonna happen. I've got some friends in some very high places, or haven't you heard, Dino?
Dig, you'll excuse me, but you may be il capo di tutti capi in Tinseltown, but in Washington, you're just a skinny wop from Hoboken.
Do you have any idea what they did for Jack?
Oh, I have an idea. Everybody has ideas.
What?
What's an idea, Frank? It's a weightless electrical charge. It don't stand up in the court of reality, which is where we're all gonna be tried.
What?
Frank. President Kennedy's online, too.
What?
President Kennedy's calling.
The president? The president's online, too, for me.
You see? The president of what? What's he the president of?
The United States.
The president of the United States? The president, on line two, for me.
I heard you the first 15 times.
You're such a pessimist.
Give my love to Jacqueline.
Jack, how are you?
Mr. Kennedy, will you address rumors of widespread voter fraud in Chicago and elsewhere in Illinois? There are those who
frankly, I believe it's irresponsible for the press to be printing baseless rumors and innuendo. My brother's president of the United States because he and others fought hard and won. Next.
Mr. Kennedy, do you expect to delve into any particular fields when you take over as Attorney General?
Yes, there are a number of areas where I think action is needed, such as I think in the field of organized crime. I think that's a very serious situation that faces this country at the present time. There are a number of steps that can be taken. I can say here today that I will make every effort to apply the full weight of this great office to put in jail hoodlums like Carlos Marcello, Momo Giancana, and Santa Traficante.
You dirty bastard!
And, crime bosses deported from this country.
Hug me.
here.
You answer that and I'll leave.
I gotta get his line number 5. It could be an emergency.
No,
nobody calls on that unless it's important. Come on. I gotta get this. Hello?
It's Roselli.
Hey, Johnny, how you doing?
Our Ava is blowing on your dice again. Maybe she likes your new Irish friends. Or maybe she's bored with bullfighters.
How did you hear that?
Jad Gahuba told me. We're on a first-name basis these days.
So what, are you going to have a fucking conversation
now? Just wait a minute?
Giancana.
Ava.
He would have called you himself. He's having a little trouble swallowing. Because while you're fucking, we're getting fucked. You're frying agony. You know how it gets, Frankie? This kind of thing makes a lot of people upset.
Okay, yeah. Okay.
There's so many bugs in the walls, we need an exterminator.
Wait a minute.
Hey, Frank, are you listening to me? Now I'm calling on behalf of Momo himself.
I'm listening.
Sam wanted me to remind you that it was you who came to us. You weren't on the line for these fucking Kennedy guys. We did our part.
Believe it.
You see Nixon on the front page every day.
I'm leaving, Frank.
How they got where they are. None of us ever expected to help us, Frankie. But we didn't expect a pinky up our ass either. Now you tell your new friend Joe Kennedy to call off that mongrel son. Put a choke chain on Bobby, you got it?
All right, I will.
You want me to tell Sam that the load is too heavy?
Go fuck yourself, Frank. Is that what you want me to tell him?
Because that's what I will. But I don't think it's the right thing to do. Now you gotta deliver us a little favor, Frank.
Go fuck yourself.
You gotta tell old man Kennedy, call off the dogs.
I will, okay.
All right, good. Now give Ava a spanking for me.
Ava, what's your problem? Ava!
I don't want to hear it.
What?
I thought maybe you'd grown up. Thought you were traveling in different circles.
You obviously don't know how things work, Ava, because the circles, they intersect.
Oh, Frank. I may be a drunken little whore, but at least I don't get into bed with men who kill people and steal for a living.
Into bed? How the hell am I into bed?
Frank, you're the biggest movie star in the goddamn world, but at the minute those two-bit thugs call you up, you fucking jump like an errand boy.
You don't turn your back on your friends.
Oh, please, you cheated on your first wife, you cheated on me, what, we weren't your friends?
When I was carrying... Come here. When I was carrying your bags like a porter...
I never treated you
when
like
I
a
When I was carrying your bags...
You like you were giving me money an artist.
Those guys stuck by me. These guys
artist.
Were the only ones who would help me out.
Are you an artist or are you a thug?
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. You don't know what you're talking about, and you never know what you're talking about. Shut up! Ava? Ava, wait a minute. Wait. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. You can't drive home.
Yeah,
Ava!
And how many times have we been through this, Frank? It's pathetic. It's pathetic.
You want to talk about pathetic? Huh? You're drinking so much, your skin's starting to feel like sandpaper, Ava. That's pathetic.
You are a bastard.
I'm sorry. Okay, I didn't mean that.
Frank. I love it when you sing. You're honest when you sing. You are an angel when you sing. Why don't you just sing?
Absolutely wonderful.
Frank, how's the president?
Needs a vacation.
Freddy, give me my drink.
Did you read the script?
An amusing story about that. I had Jack read it, you see. And he says it's a remake of Gunga Din.
You don't like your part, Peter. We could always find another Englishman.
I didn't say that. I didn't say that.
When am I coming, Peter? It's been 4 months. He's making me look bad.
Working on that, Frank. It's just a little different these days, that's all.
How's that?
Well, you're still Frank Sinatra, but Jack's president now.
With a lot of help from me and my friends.
Yeah, I realize that, but...
You go to the White House, don't you, Peter?
Yeah, not that often these days, considering the crises and everything. But it's family, Frank. It's family.
Now Joe treats you like a son, does he? Don't squirm, Peter. I hate it when you squirm.
Yeah. Sometimes I'm not so sure, Frank.
Judy, well, what do you know? The hard-on stretches from Palm Springs to the White House and all the way back here to Chicago.
Frankly, I'm amazed you think you can walk into the office of the Attorney General with crap like this. Now, whatever favors Giancana says he did on behalf of the family, I'm going to act in the best interest of this country, which means ridding the nation of the likes of him, Hoffa, Trafficante, and all the rest.
This just came from Hoover.
Thanks.
That's all very well, Bobby, but it's like, banking, really. Favor banking, you see? You have to look at it from their point of view. They did us a favor, now they want a favor in return.
Listen to me. They may be a bunch of well-dressed nightclub owners with cute nicknames to you, Peter. But the truth is, they steal, they murder, they extort, and they corrupt. And I intend to ram the Washington Monument right up their rear ends. Understand?
Of course I understand, Bobby.
Well, thanks for your time.
The Bay of Pigs continues to haunt the president. With over 1,500 men still rotting in a Cuban prison, the war of words between Castro and the United States grew even hotter today as Castro lambasted the young president as a naked aggressor.
Give me some good news, Peter. Who's Frank sleeping with these days?
Well, Ava came back for about 5 minutes.
I hear she's a formidable woman.
Oh,
good morning, Evelyn. Tell Frank we'll have him over soon.
That's good, because he's been asking about that, actually.
I'm sure he has. But Jackie doesn't want him in the house. Thinks he's a bad influence.
Well, maybe we could stuff him into one of John John's diaper bags and smuggle him in, yeah?
I think Jackie's out of town next month. We could have him up then. Have Eunice be the hostess. Take him up to Hyannisport, go for a sail.
It's good. He'd like that.
It's good to see you again, Peter. Oh, Peter.
Yes.
Say hello to, you know who.
Of course. Mr. President.
Janet. Fine, Bobby.
Pick it up, Bill. Let's pick it up a little.
Yeah. Here's my umbrella. It's the least I can do.
Yeah. I like
wonderful.
That.
Wonderful.
Yeah, that's wonderful. The G7 chord, could we go to the E on that instead of the E flat? Make it a little brighter. It's the least I can do. Yeah, it's wonderful. It's wonderful. Oh, Charlie Pentagon.
Hello, boys. Hello, Cedric. Frank.
Hey, Peter. I'm gonna be a daddy.
Hey.
Yeah, I just want them all to be tall and healthy like you, baby.
I don't know. It looks like he's shrinking. Are you shrinking, Cedric?
No. I'm sailing, Frank. I'm sailing through life without a care in the world.
And on that note, manana, rats. Come on, Wyatt, let's take a turn.
All right. Divvy up. What's going on?
Well, I'm starting to feel like a messenger boy, Frank, and I don't like it.
That's the way to stand up for yourself. It's the word, Peter.
The word is, I want you to come next month.
Ah, there you go. Ah, now you're singing in tune.
Okay, now, I gotta get him something. What should I get him? What should I get him?
Well, what do you get, the man who has everything?
You can never have too much, Peter. You should know that.
Yeah. Also, I had a chat with Bobby. Told me to fuck off.
Do you realize the position that puts me in?
No. No, I don't want to know, Frank. You see, I'm an actor, Frank. I'm just an actor. Not a messenger boy. And it's humiliating. Do you understand that? I've got the President of the United States of America passing messages through me to Marilyn Monroe, who happens to be drinking out of a flask at the moment. And then I've got Bobby Kennedy, who's passing messages through me to you, and you're passing messages to Joe Kennedy. And you know what? I just want to act, Frank. I just want to act and cheat on my wife. Is it too much to ask? Is it too much to ask?
1 minute he says he's talked to Bobby, the next minute he says he hasn't. It's a lot of shit.
Frank says to me, Johnny, I took Sam's name, I wrote it down, I showed it to Bobby Kennedy. I said, this guy is my buddy. This is what I want you to know.
When he says he's gonna do a guy a favor?
I mean, look, if he can't deliver, he should come to me and say, John, the load is too heavy.
Then Frank's gonna have to do you a little favor.
You see Kennedy and them guys? They treat him like he's a whore. I see you go the other way, Mo. Fuck him. Let him see the other side of you. Show these Hollywood rats they can't do this like nothing ever happened. Let's hit him. Let's hit Sinatra. And I'll wipe the rest of those guys while I'm at it. Lawford, Martin, that fucking Munja Fregis, I wipe that bad attitude right off his face. And the nigga, too. I take his other eye out. Bing! Just like that. So what do you think? Let's whack them all.
Nah. I want to hear Frank sing Chicago again. I love the way he does that.
As tight as you go, Frank.
This is the ultimate, Jack. Sailing under the presidential flag. It's a long way from Hoboken.
Holding Marilyn is like holding an ancient Roman vase. You have to be careful it doesn't turn to dust in your hands.
You're living dangerously, Jack.
Life is short, Frank, and Marilyn is so soft.
Her skin is like
Electric Velvet.
Yes, Electric Velvet. How's Ava?
Ava is bourbon sliding down your throat, spreading its wings in your chest like a butterfly.
She's pure heartache.
I miss her even when I'm having her.
We're in the wrong racket, Frank. We should spend our time in coffee houses singing the praises of women like a couple of beatnik poets. Listen, I'm going to be out your way in March. Think you can put me up? I have a tad more baggage this time, however.
Are you kidding me? I'll build a whole new wing for you, Jack. Of course I'll put you up.
That's fantastic. What about Bobby?
The Roman vase of presidential prerogative was still intact last time I checked. I'll bring some Cuban cigars. We'll sit around your pool and forget about war and racism and life's other perplexing irony.
That'd be great, Jack.
Newsflash. Frank Sinatra is telling everyone in Hollywood that President Kennedy will use Sinatra's Palm Springs estate as the Western White House.
All right, this is going to be Jack's. Right up here.
Mm-hmm. Sinatra has been absent from the Washington scene since the inauguration.
And the Secret Service. Now we're going to build 5 bungalows down on the hillside.
Some say it's the Bay of Pigs fiasco that has kept Sinatra from a presidential visit.
I want this done by March.
But this informed reporter says it's the First Lady, who's none too fond of perennial bad boy Francis Albert.
Done by March.
Good evening, Mr. President, General.
Good evening, Jefferson. How are you tonight?
Very well, sir. Looks like your freshman must win.
They say it's good for the back. Jefferson, do we have any pistachio?
Yes, I stocked up on it, sir. Let me get it.
Oh, here it is. Never mind. Bobby? How do you stand on mixing peach and chocolate?
I'm against it.
Mr. President, I'd be more than happy to prepare it for you.
Oh, you probably had a harder day than I have, Jefferson. Go to bed. Besides, don't tell the First Lady, but my brother likes to eat his ice cream right out of the tub. Bobby, make yourself useful. Get the sprinkles.
Oh, I don't think that's in my purview.
I'll get it.
No. He's acting in a dual capacity. I've just appointed the Attorney General, Secretary of Sprinkles as well. Spoons, Bobby, and a bowl for me.
General.
Huh. Good night, Jefferson.
Good night, Mr. President.
Good night, Jefferson.
Good night, General.
Sprinkles.
So, where was I?
Ice cream always seems so naked without sprinkles. Pistachio?
Chocolate, Jack. Now, can we get back to this?
Yes, I know. You've received a memo from the guardian of all that is right and decent.
A memo saying that a woman named Judy Campbell has been seen with Giancana, and that they've traced several calls from her to you in the Oval Office.
That evil old queer. What's the matter? Isn't he getting his estrogen? You tell Hoover I've heard of a certain photograph, him and Clyde Tolson, that might raise an eyebrow or two.
Jack, this is serious.
I am serious.
It has to stop, Jack, today. How can we wield our moral influence in Jackson, Mississippi, when Hoover could be sharing this crap with our enemies down there? I've also had a memo from Hoover saying he thinks the CIA may be plotting with Giancana and Trafficante to get Castro.
It's all about layers, Bobby. Like a woman. Who wants a woman who just appears naked in your bed and spreads her legs? Where's the sport in that? No. The name of the game is hide and seek. You have to cover the prize with sprinkles, and then, voila, pistachio.
You can't stay at Sinatra's house in Palm Springs. Be pen pals, talk on the phone. But the President of the United States can't sleep in the same bed that Sam Giancana slept in. Not while I'm Attorney General.
You don't think he's changed the sheets, Bobby?
Fucking Kennedys!
Fucking Frank.
There's no limit to the money, and no, I want
okay.
As many people.
We
need
30
guys.
Morning, Peter.
Done. I told you, I'm on a deadline here. You know the deadline?
Yes.
I know the deadline. Let's get it done.
You got it.
Hey, brother-in-law. Here, take a look at this.
Look, it looks great, doesn't it? Looks great. You know, George, get Peter some breakfast. All right, this is right up here. That's Jack's room.
I'm going to have phone lines installed so each room is connected privately to the presidential suite. So that'll be great.
Yeah, fabulous, Frank. It's absolutely fabulous.
Excuse me. Can you give us take 10 minutes, all right? Just 10. What's the matter with you? You look like you swallowed a stone. What's going on?
I need a drink.
Mind if I have a drink?
Yeah. Hold your horse and I'll get you a drink.
Jack can't stay here next month. The Secret Service says it's a bad security risk.
What?
Whoa.
A bad security risk? What are you talking about?
I've pleaded your case, Frank.
There's nothing. Where's he gonna stay?
Bings.
Crosby's? Crosby's a fucking Republican. How can he stay there?
I know, Frank.
I spent hundreds of thousands of dollars here, Peter. Everyone knows he's staying here.
I've argued your case, Frank. There's nothing I can do about it, okay? He's staying.
Tell me the truth. You tell me the goddamn truth, because what you're saying is bullshit.
You want to know the truth. Tell me the truth. You know the truth. You know it. Everybody knows the truth except for you and Jack, because you're so arrogant.
This is Bobby, isn't it?
No, it's...
This is Bobby, that little motherfucker.
No, it's not
this
Bobby.
This is Bobby,
it's
that
you
little motherfucker.
And Jack.
After what I did for them... After what their own fucking father asked me to do for
them. You're both so arrogant that you think the rules don't apply to you. Well, they apply to you, Frank. The rules apply.
Jack doesn't want this, does he? No, Jack didn't want this.
You think that the rules don't apply to you?
Jack is my friend. Jack is my friend.
You arrogant son of a bitch.
Are you going to be staying at Bing's? Are you staying at Bing's? Are you staying at Bing's?
It's family, Frank.
Get out of here, Peter. That's it. It's over.
Don't play with me.
Get out. No more movies. No more nothing, Peter.
This is my
fault. Get out of my house.
Frank, hey, what the hell is going on?
Come on, Dean, say something.
Don't you take his side.
What's the problem, Pally?
Stay out of it, Dean.
Frank, please.
Sammy. Don't you take his side. Get
Sammy.
Out. Peter, get out of here. Stop it. No more hammering, no more nails, nothing. Everybody out. You're fired. John, it's over. Stop painting, stop nails, no nothing. Get out. All of you, get out. Shut up.
He's crazy.
Get out of here. Get out. Move.
We're all crazy.
Don't fret, okay, Peter? He'll get over it. He will.
No. Not this time.
Peter, come on, man.
Quarter to three. There's no one in the place except you and me. So set 'em up, Joe. got a little story I think you should know. We're drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. I got the routine, put another nickel in the machine. Feeling so bad, can't you make the music easy and sad?
We are confronted primarily with a moral issue. It is as old as the scriptures and is as clear as the American Constitution. The heart of the question is whether all Americans are to be afforded equal rights and equal opportunities. If an American, because his skin is dark, cannot enjoy a full and free life, then who among us would be content to have the color of his skin changed and stand in his place? Who among us would then be content with the counsels of patience and delay? And this nation, for all its hopes and all its boasts, will not be fully free until all its citizens are free.
I'd like to say, and when I'm gloomy, won't you listen to me till it's talked away? That's how it goes. And Joe, I know you're getting anxious to close. Thanks for the cheer. I hope you didn't mind my bending your ear. But this torch that I found, it's gotta be drowned, or it soon might explode. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. That long, so
the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow, got the string around my finger. What a world, what a life, I'm in love. I got a song that I sing, I can make the rain go anytime I move my finger. It's a beautiful thing, as long as I hold the string. I'd be a silly so-and-so if I should ever let it go. I got the world on a string, sitting on a rainbow, got the string around my finger. What a world, what a life, I'm in love. life is a beautiful thing. As long as I hold the string, I'd be a silly so-and-so if I should ever let it go.